Now, here is a funny guy, one of my favorites. And if he's not already one of yours, he soon will be. Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Mule Deer.
Thank you, Rick. Thank you. Just walking around the parking lot, it's windy out there. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. I feel for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell in. A couple of months ago, checked into a hotel, there was a Bible beside the bed. I opened it up, there's a message inside that said, if you are an alcoholic, if you think you have a drinking problem, please call this number. I called it, it was a liquor store. Let it out, folks, doesn't get any better. My grandpa used to say, listen, if we all liked the same things, everybody'd be after your grandma. Grandpa used to say some weird things. One time I said, Grandpa, what's the quickest way to get to the lake? He said, you walking or driving? I said, I'm driving. He said, that's the quickest. Make fun of Grandpa. Actually, he was pretty successful. He was a veterinarian and a taxidermist. The sign said, no matter what happens, you'll get your dog back. You guys are all right. Want to go to Denny's later? Took Grandpa to Denny's one time. The coffee was cold, eggs were runny, the hash browns were soggy, the toast was burned. As we were leaving, Grandpa turned to the cashier and he said, my compliments to the photographer. Grandpa really hated Grandma's cooking. He said it got so bad there for a while, all the flies chipped in and got the screen door fixed. You guys are all right. It's turning out much better than I thought it would. My name is Gary Mule Deer. It's not my real name. I changed it. My real name's Elizabeth Mule Deer. I remember one time when I was in Sunday school, I was trying to look up this little girl's dress, and the teacher caught me. She said, Gary, would Jesus do something like that? I said, well, no, he'd probably just create a big wind and blow the whole thing up. All right, here we go. This work a test? Test check. One, two. Old couple walking down the street. Pigeon flies over. Lets one go. Hits the old man right in the forehead. The old lady says, geez, I wish we had some toilet paper. The old man said, what the heck for? He must be half mile away by now. Stuff works better down here. Guy walks into Sears with a seeing eye dog, goes into the men's department, picks up the seeing eye dog by the tail, starts swinging it around his head. Manager walks up, says, can I help you? He says, no, we're just looking around.
Well, since my memory left me, I've found a new place to dwell. It's down at the...
So this burglar is going through a bedroom. He hears this voice over in the corner say, Jesus is watching you. He turns around, there's no one there. Starts to unplug the television, he hears this voice again. Jesus is watching you. Takes out his flashlight. Over in the corner, there's a cage with a parrot in it. Burglar says, was that you? The parrot says, yes, it was. The burglar says, well, what's your name? The parrot says, my name is Moses. Burglar says, well, what kind of a family would name a parrot Moses? The parrot said, the same family that named our Rottweiler Jesus. Like dog jokes, huh? Great. Dog walks into a bar, climbs up on a bar stool, says, I'll have a beer. Bartender says, that's amazing. You should be in a circus. Dog said, why? Do they need electricians? It's a musician's joke, all right? So this teacher is talking to her students about whales. She said, although the whale's a very large mammal, it has a very small throat, incapable of swallowing a human being. Little girl raises her hand and says, well, what about Jonah? He was swallowed by a whale. Teacher said, once again, large mammal, small throat, no danger whatsoever to human being. Little girl says, when I get to heaven, I'm going to ask Jonah. Teacher said, well, what if Jonah went to hell? Little girl said, then you ask him.
Whoa.
This couple's walking down the beach, 60 years old. They're celebrating their 40th wedding anniversary. A genie appears, says, I'm going to give you each one wish. Takes the wife to the side, says, what's your wish? She said, you know, I've always wanted to travel the world for a couple of years. Just like that, fistful of airline tickets, helicopter arrives to take her to a cruise ship. Genie turns to the husband, he says, what about you? He says, you know, I've always wanted a wife 30 years younger than me. And just like that, he was 90. Oh, husband and wife jokes, huh? All right. Here's one I've never done before. This is the first time for TV, stage, anything. This couple's Christmas shopping. Woman looks around, notices her husband isn't there anymore, calls him on the cell phone, says, where are you? We have a lot of things to do today. He said, you know that jeweler that we ran into, that jewelry shop about 10 years ago, and you fell in love with that diamond necklace? And I said I couldn't afford it at the time, but sometime I was going to get it for you. She got kind of teary-eyed. She says, yes, I do remember. He said, well, I'm in the golf shop right next door to that. So I guess I better close real quickly here. Mother walks into her son's bedroom, says, get up, it's time to go to church. He said, I'm not going. She said, get up and get dressed, you're going to church. He said, give me one good reason. She said, I'll give you three. Number one, I'm your mother. Number two, you're 52 years old. You've been living here ever since you got out of high school. And number three, you're the pastor. Thanks, you guys. You're incredible. Now, when I heard the sound of Johnny Cash and Sun Records in the 1950s, I wanted to get into show business. I almost didn't get to hear the sound of Johnny Cash and Sun Records. You didn't either. You don't realize this, but in 1955 in Los Angeles, California, Frank Sinatra was working on a song that went something like this. I hear that train a-coming, doobie 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 doo. That exact same time in Memphis, Tennessee, Johnny Cash was working on this song. Start spreading the news, I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it, New York, New York. Thank God they switched songs. I hear that train coming, it's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. Yeah, I'm stuck in Folsom Prison. Time keeps dragging on. Kobe keeps a sissy. But that train keeps rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno, yeah, just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blow, I hang my head and I cry. Let's hear a little bit of Luther here. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can be free. But those people keep a moving, and that's what tortures me. One more time, let's play that one. Pretty good, isn't it? Said I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Yeah, far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay.
I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
That was great. Sounds just like Cash to me, I tell you. But, you know, I have some good stories about Roger Miller, too.
Oh, boy. I got some stories about Roger. I worked with Roger for 7 years on the road. Roger gave me a show business tip once. He said, never play in your hometown, never take a wood into a sand trap, and never carry your picks and your pills in the same box.
Well, you know, he used to... take a few pills, I understand.
Yes, he did. Roger and I used to spend a lot of days up. We used to go to bed on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. It was amazing.
Well, you know, when he walked, he sounded like a maraca.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember one time we were working in Atlantic City at the Claridge Hotel in Atlantic City, and they asked him to be the head of the Easter Parade. They wanted to be the Grand Marshal of the Easter Parade. He said, if I do it, Mule Deer has to do it. So at 7 a.m., we're out on the boardwalk, and it's cold on the ocean. And there's three vintage cars. There's Roger and Mary Miller will be in the first car. The mayor of Atlantic City and last year's Miss Atlantic City and Miss Atlantic City in the very back of the car. And the third car was the water commissioner. They said, well, where's Mule Deer going to ride? So they took the water commissioner out, took the sign off, and we're going up and down the boardwalk, like 10 miles an hour, freezing. And nobody knows who I am because I have no sign on the side. Just as we're making the turn to come back down the boardwalk, some lady yells to me, who are you? I yelled, Pia Zadora. She yelled back, your movie sucks.
Well, you know what I like about you, though? You don't use any four-letter words in your act.
No, I don't, man. I just never have. But I have four-letter words all around me. My name is three four-letter words. Gary Mule Deer. I mean, I play golf. I think about joke. I think about sing, show, play, all this stuff that are four-letter words. But that's the only ones I use. I don't think adult humor is very grown up.
I don't know. I do this, and that's why I'm going to bring out the fact that you carry a lot of notes in your pockets.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah.
We were talking before the show about the hillbilly teleprompters. And, turns out he has one, too. He didn't know what to call it, though.
How men and women record things in their diaries. Tonight, I thought my husband was acting weird. We had made plans to meet at a nice restaurant for dinner. I was shopping with my friends all day long, so I thought he was upset at the fact I was a bit late, but he made no comment. Conversation wasn't flowing, so I suggested we find a table in the back so we could talk. He said, fine, but nothing else. I asked him what was wrong. He said, nothing, don't worry about it. On the way home, I told him that I loved him. He smiled slightly, patted my arm, and kept driving. I don't know why he didn't say I love you, too. When we got home, I felt as if I'd lost him completely. He just sat there quietly and watched TV. Finally, with silence all around us, I just went in and went to bed. 15 minutes later, he came in, rolled over, and went to sleep. My marriage is in a shambles. I've been crying for an hour. I don't know what to do. Husband's diary. A 2-foot putt. Who in the hell misses a 2-foot putt?
Oh, God. Listen, I got to ask.
What? We've been out here a while. Let's see what's going on in the news, real quick here. Oh, it says scientists now tell us that the fastest animal on Earth with a top speed of over 120 feet per second. Is a cow that's been dropped out of a helicopter. Terrible. So bad.
Who were your influences?
Jack Benny. I influenced Ray. Jack Benny. Eve Arden. They were my two comedy influences. Johnny Cash, of course, I learned to sing with his records. But I never hung out with comedians a lot. When I started doing comedy, I did 15, 20 years, 25 years in comedy clubs. But I was always I was never a stand-up comedian. I always hung out with guys like you, funny musicians. That's who I liked. I liked guys like, well, Jack Benny was a funny musician. But I liked the Smothers Brothers. I liked Steve Martin. I liked...
Got a question. Were you and Steve Martin roommates
yes,
at one
we
time?
Yes, we were, as a matter of fact. We were roommates during when he was writing the Smothers Brothers show. As a matter of fact... He couldn't write anything, and Tommy came up and said, you've got to come up with something, Steve, for this bit in the show. We're going to have to let you go. So he called me, and I had two things in my show. He says, can I use them? I said, sure, and he went back. And I one of them was, female impersonators are great on dates because they can change tires. And I can't remember the other one, but anyway.
Well, you know, Steve Martin was a writer on my show.
I know, that's right.
In 1970.
That's right, he did.
And I thought he was the strangest guy I'd ever met.
He's a very strange guy, but I'll tell you, you know, incredible banjo player, incredible musician.
Oh, yeah, he is.
The absolute best.
He came up with the arrow through the head
on
my show,
yeah.
As well as a lot of the other things that have become synonymous with the name Steve Martin.
That's right, and that's why I take the arrow now and shoot it. I tape a rubber chicken to the microphone, put a cigarette in his mouth, walk off 30 feet, and using my guitar as a bow, I shoot the cigarette out of the chicken's mouth.
Can you really do that?
Yeah, I really do that, honestly. Really,
on stage?
Yes. Speaking of musicians.
And you never miss?
No, I never miss. Speaking of musicians, look at this. I can't believe this. Look what this says. 5 rules for men to follow for a happy life, according to all the guys in the Ray Stevens Orchestra. Listen to this. Number one, it is important to have a woman who helps at home, who cooks from time to time, cleans up, and has a job. Number two, it is important to have a woman that can make you laugh. Number three, it is important to have a woman who you can trust and who doesn't lie to you. Number four, it is important to have a woman who is nice to sleep with and who likes to be with you. And number five, it is very, very important that these four women do not know each other.
Thanks for being here, Gary. It's been a lot of fun. Ladies and gentlemen,
you.
Gary Mule Deer.
Thank you all. Great. Thanks, man. Thank you. All right.